We started the camp 2 years ago in the season, the 2010 season. What we came up with was the boys would put on a Special Olympics camp where they would be the coaches and direct it and run the whole thing. And Special Olympic athletes from around Montana would get to have a free camp and this amazing experience, interact and learn about soccer and leadership and other things, and the boys would lead that camp or direct it.
The camp itself, I think, is a great thing because it's a day where Special Olympic athletes get to be the center of attention. They have all of this attention from the regular ed soccer players, and they learn skills, they have social interactions, they get shirts, which they all love, shirts and medals and food and drinks, and it's a day where they are just the kings and the queens.
You know, I really think that it's one of the more valuable things that we do here. Number one, the thing that you've put together with this Special Olympics camp, it allows for a real service learning project, and I don't think we get those opportunities enough, and hardly at all at the high school level.
After we did our first Special Olympics camp, and by doing it in the middle of the season, that it was this phenomenal confidence booster and team building exercise to watch the boys interact with the Special Olympic athletes and be in such a giving activity, that they were giving so much of themselves and sharing so much laughter together that they were expected to show a lot more emotion and care about something. And so it's just a stroke of luck, and we can't take credit for it, though we try to sometimes talk about the genius of how it's a great team builder. We do it always the first Saturday of October, which is right smack dab in the middle of our season, and it just pays huge dividends for us.
Even more important, I think, to me as a special ed teacher, as well as a Special Olympic coordinator, is the fact that they're working on appropriate social interactions with the regular ed students who are the soccer players. These are the kids that they see in the hallways, they see when they go out to lunch or out to dinner or to the mall, and they're building friendships, they're building advocacy.
It was really important to me when I first started coaching that soccer became more than just a simple, athletic experience for kids, but that kids were really learning deep values and and understanding the privilege that they have to play soccer and represent their school. And I wanted the value that they got out of it to say they have an obligation back to their community to serve it. And so that was it. We were looking for something that we felt would teach values to our boys and a way to give back to their community.
And I think having the boys' programs and the girls' programs work together, I think it's such a valuable part, because so often we do separate ourselves into smaller and smaller groups, offense and defense, or JV and varsity, but rarely do we get to have everybody come together who's all here for the same purpose. We like soccer, we love to play the game, and we really like being part of a team, dynamic. And so I think those things all combine to make this one of the better experiences we have here for our soccer players at Big Sky.
All right, so in the beginning of the camp, we meet all the athletes, and it's a great moment because all the players are really ecstatic to be there, and it makes all of the coaches feel a lot really professional, and that's a good feeling. And right there is where we develop this personal relationship where we're not all soccer players anymore, we're all friends, and I think that's one of the most important aspects of the camp.
The first step to meeting someone is their name. is the simplest step, and that's where you start with the handshake line. You get that first interaction and the first hello, I guess. You get to see people that you've seen in the past years or new people.
My athlete was Blaguna. I was assigned to her, and we worked with her all day on her skills. And we got to talk to her and just get to know her before even doing or playing soccer. And so the cool thing was you got to know your player as a person instead of just a soccer player. And that way you get to understand why they are even there and what they want to accomplish over the day.
Lunch was awesome. It was, I'd have to say it's about another best part of the camp is just being able to sit down with your Special Olympian and just talk. It doesn't have to be really based on anything. It can be based on whatever it wants to be, from soccer to just daily lives.
After lunch, we start focusing more on soccer, and that's when we do a dynamic warm-up. And we keep the dynamic warm-up identical as we would do it before a game ourselves, because that's just showing the players the importance of dynamic stretching and that they're getting this equal opportunity as we do. And there we just focus on the stretching with them, and it's really great to see how serious they take it all and how important the warm-up is to them, and we like to reflect that by being really serious about it too. After our dynamic warm-up, we go into all sorts of drills. We normally pretty much cover anything there is in soccer. Goes through shooting, to throw-ins, to dribbling. And one of my favorite ones in particular is shooting. Celebrating with the athletes and having them celebrate is just so great to see, because they're all happy as they can be when they score. When all the athletes are celebrating together, it's just great to see them all come together.
My athlete, Blaguna, decided when everyone was hugging her to just yell, "Hooray for friends!" And with that, everybody started chanting, "Hooray for friends!" And we all were just hooraying.
I worked with Chris this year, the goalkeeper that they had. He was really good. We worked on some basics, just hand stuff and then distribution, really. And he did really good in the scrimmage, which I thought was awesome.
So the scrimmage is just like a normal soccer game. It's not necessarily competitive. It's just everybody going out there and having fun, showing off what they learned during the camp. And you're, as a player and a coach, are playing with the athletes, which shows them maybe if they don't know what to do, they can ask you for help. And even if somebody gets frustrated during the scrimmage, there's other people there that will bring them back up and make sure that they are enjoying themselves and being part of the game.
That has to be one of my favorite moments of the camp, because all the athletes are now playing other athletes. They're no longer, that barrier between us and them is kind of lifted.
We decided to cheer for them, and I put some European cheering on the bench, and we had an awesome time. And they hear us cheering, and so they felt really special.
It was really cool to see them all playing together, because the scrimmage was at the end where we had kind of left and just kind of observed and watched, and they could all work together as one. And I thought that was really cool to see them at the beginning, some of them not knowing each other at all, really, and then becoming teammates on the field just like we do.
So at the award ceremony, each coach, which is matched to a player, brings up their player and tells something that they did well or something that they recognized about their player.
In my instance, I had Coulter, and I talked about Coulter's personality in and off the soccer field, and just about how he's a great guy and he's a great player, and his shots and his passing were all perfect for what he was trying to accomplish to that day.
Each individual that was at the camp did something that was like revealed to all of us that was really important, and I feel that it was really good that we did that, because it, for one, makes them really happy and feel like they accomplished something, but also us have the benefit of letting them know that we were really proud of them for what they did.
And they get their medals and they love those. They hang them up in their rooms and you have parents come and say, oh, she has three of them already, and it's pretty great.
It topped everything, was just seeing them get the awards and how proud they were to get it. I'd have to say it was just awesome seeing everybody so cheerful.
At the end of the camp, after we've done award ceremony and everything, we have a bunch of team pictures printed out of the girls and boys team, because both participate. And they each get a picture, boys and girls, and walk down a line of tables with that Big Sky athletes on one side and the Special Olympian athletes on the other side. And they just have us sign their pictures. They love it. I just see them smiling the entire time. And honestly, as being a Big Sky athlete myself, it makes me feel great about myself. It makes me feel, oh, they like what I'm doing. I love what I'm doing. I think it definitely builds a stronger relationship, even signing a piece of paper with your picture on it.
The autographs were a lot of fun because I never signed autographs like this, but you didn't feel like, oh, I'm a pro. You signed them like friends. You spent the whole day with them, and they get to know you, and it's like they took something with them, and it was a great day.
All the athletes treat you like you're a famous soccer player, and having that kind of honor really makes you feel like you did something important that day. And it's not only important to you, but you realize how much they cherish and they value this camp that you put on for them. And that's a feeling you can't really get from anything else.
I think it is a valuable experience to have as a team, because you're making relationships with them, but you're also seeing your team in another light. You're watching them, how they react with other people, how they react with you, and it's a great team bonding experience because you're not just having fun with the Special Olympians, but you're mixing in with girls on your team or boys on your team, and you get to have fun and have that experience with each other as well as the Olympian.
I think it's really valuable because it's not only a coaching aspect, but it's also just doing something as a team. And we feel at Big Sky that soccer is a privilege that we have, and kind of showing how much we appreciate this privilege by showing it to like our community and these athletes is just something we feel like that needs to be done.
I thought it was just really neat to finally have an experience like that, because me personally have never done anything with like Special Olympians before, and I just thought it was really cool to make them feel just as a part of the team as I am, or just as important as everyone makes me feel.
I was so stoked this year. Last year was amazing, but this year topped it off for me. It was just being able to help them out so much. I'm planning on coaching in the spring with them, doing as much as I can there.
This experience made me, of course, want to come back next year and the year after that, and just as many times as I can, and help out, because knowing that you helped somebody and made somebody so happy is really great.
I don't think there is a day where you are going to find as many smiles coming off the field. I don't know if winning their fourth straight championship in a row is going to give you the same feeling of personal accomplishment as what I saw the pride with every one of our players walking off that field that day. So I think just knowing that students come in perhaps a little apprehensive and walk out, you know, 3 feet taller is a pretty neat experience.
I have to go back to what I think it does for young men in their growth and development to, A, give, to show a side of themselves that a lot of our society doesn't expect of them to show, instead be macho and if not be macho, worry about being crushed by beer cans. I think it's really funny that these boys instead are unafraid and brave in the face of that high school experience to just be real people and open up and share with these athletes.
I think it's so important, not just to the Special Olympic athletes, but I think it's really important because it builds education and tolerance in the general population, they learn about people with disabilities, and they learn how cool they can be and how amazing and the skills that they have, and that they have to overcome so many things, and they most of the time do it with amazing attitudes, and they're happy and they're just thankful and grateful, and they come in, and it might even make a difference to kids without disabilities, and they think, oh, maybe our lives aren't so bad at all, and maybe my life is a lot easier. So I think the education part of that, as far as building tolerance and acceptance within the community, is huge, and that's one of the things that the soccer camp does.
What I like most about the camp, and I've recently just like gotten more into, is just the fact of being able to work with kids that are different than what I always grew up with. Just because they're different doesn't mean that they aren't great people. They probably teach me more than I teach them. It's a lot of fun. You get to work with them and you just smile the entire day because they're always willing to try so hard and always try their best, and they want it. They want to do it. They love being out there and doing it and having fun and being a part of a team, being a part of that sport that they enjoy.
Bam, 10, hut!
1!